Sheikh Hormak, I hear you are the Templar's new don of precursor archaeology.
I'm no expert, sir. I just witnessed what the assassins can do with those damn sites.
I have spent years investigating precursor leads. Tell me what you have seen.
Well, I know both the assassins and Templars are looking for pieces of Eden. Powerful weapons, mind-controlling apples, but this time it's different. We haven't found an apple, but a tree. These temples hold the earth together like roots. Disturb them, and Haiti falls, or Lisbon, or any other place the manuscript shows.
And the assassins are blindly interfering with these structures?
Aye. And if we don't stop them, they'll continue destroying cities.
I see. We have intelligence of assassin activity in the Lugeburg Fortress. We'll be meeting with a Royal Navy officer, James Cook. He recently gained a commission that could be strategically valuable. Gist has the charts.
Very well. I'll depart shortly.
Colonel Monroe spoke highly of you, Shay. He was convinced you could become the best among us. I expect you will not disappoint.
I don't plan to, sir.
Gist, do you know why the Grand Master is so interested in Captain Cook?
Well, sir, he's very intelligent and ambitious. His knowledge of seamanship is second to none. And if I trust my favorite barmaid in Halifax, he also just became captain of his own man of war. He's also an expert at deciphering secret codes. A man with such a skill is certainly an asset to our cause.
The kind of fellow we should welcome in the Order, then.
Well, he's a friend of mine, but the man has an annoying habit of strict honesty and a total lack of anything resembling guile. Makes it a little hard to keep secret business secret, especially when his mathematical brain is clever at cracking codes. Consider him an ally, but watch what you say around him.
Duly noted.
This... Unlash the harpoons!
As we were fishing off Haysboro Light, when the wind blows, we'll all pull together.
There he goes!
We had him on the line!
Hold steady now! Hold steady now! Brace!
Grand shot, Captain!
Success!
Watch out! Ice! Nice shot!
Hang on, man!
Great haul, sir.
What sail as you can!
Loose topsails, gallants and royals! Someone mentions hell freezing over. I will think back fondly on these days.
Fire!
Our hands have turned to ice. Valuable cargo.
This is more like it.
Thank you.
said come.
Gist, do you know why the Grand Master is so interested in Captain Cook?
Well, sir, he's very intelligent and ambitious. His knowledge of seamanship is second to none. And if I trust my favorite barmaid in Halifax, he also just became captain of his own man of war.
Loose and Trim too. Loose all.
He's also an expert at deciphering secret codes. A man with such a skill is certainly an asset to our cause.
The kind of fellow we should welcome in the Order, then.
Well, he's a friend of mine, but the man has an annoying habit of strict honesty and a total lack of anything resembling guile. Makes it a little hard to keep secret business secret, especially when his mathematical brain is clever at cracking codes. Consider him an ally, but watch what you say around him.
Duly noted.
I've heard Louisbourg could be a linchpin in the war. If the Royal Navy can take that fort, it'll be clear sailing down the St. Lawrence.
Then on to Quebec and Montreal. The tide is turning.
General Wolfe will give that craven Montcalm a right thrashing.
I've been looking forward to that since Fort William Henry.
With this bloody war over, we'll finally bring order to this damn continent.
I fear it would take more than that, Greg.
It takes a strong constitution to survive out here. That's your whiskey.
Ease off the wind! Loose down! Catch some wind!
Loose sails! Let's catch the wind!
Cargo for the taking, sir.
Fire! Fire!
Here they go!
Fire! Set the mainsails into the wind!
A fine ship for the fleet, Captain.
Clew up! Clew up!
Act like an officer!
Get me some speed!
There she is! The HMS Pembroke. Captain James Cook's ship.
She's a beauty.
Man of war. Fully armed. We should bring the Morrigan alongside. Master Kenway will surely be waiting.
Welcome aboard, gentlemen.
Good to see you again, Captain.
Captain Shay Cormac, Captain James Cook.
Pleased to make your acquaintance.
Pleasure's mine, sir.
Captain Cook uncovered a rather distressing stratagem, which I fear confirms our own intelligence.
Indeed. As we speak, our Royal Navy fleet is on its way to Louisbourg. However, the French have drawn up a preemptive strike against it. If they launch this attack...
Obviously, we cannot allow that to happen. Gentlemen. The Battle of Louisbourg could very well be the turning point which will finally bring this war to a close.
I don't know about you, but I've had enough of war.
Then may I suggest you take the wheel, Captain Cormac? I think you might enjoy piloting a vessel with real, firepower.
I believe I shall, Captain.
Wolfe, Lawrence, and Whitmore lead the three divisions of the Royal Navy.
Who's their commander?
Major General Amherst himself, back from Hanover.
You take an interest in the war, Shay?
Wouldn't want to disappoint you, sir.
It is imperative we stop these ships.
The
outcome of the war.
Captain, on to the flag!
Make good use of your own quarters. Prove crucial if you are to succeed.
Take a load of them out!
Damage report!
Fire!
Ready, Captain!
Fire!
Hit her from a safe range!
Fire!
Dear God, fire ships. Should they break through, they would devastate our fleet.
And we'd better not let that happen.
I recognize that vessel, sir. It's the Experto Crede.
And why?
How fortunate he is that we have other priorities.
Agreed. We have to get rid of those fire ships.
Cannon ready!
Spread our wings to the wind!
Loose sails! Let's...
Wisdom don't always mix, Captain. This isn't over yet, lads. Man the cannons!
The Royal Navy. We cleared the way just in time, Captain Cormac.
The tide of war is turning.
That was quite a crack, wasn't it?
It is too soon for celebrations. Adewale is still out there.
I'm sure we'll get another turn to dance with him, Master Kenway.
Kenway seems determined to destroy Adewale.
Aren't you? He's a powerful man in his own right, and a symbol of hope for the Assassins. Eliminating him would shake them to their core.
It would, I know. But it seems a shame. He's a good man, Gist.
So was the Elder Washington, and Smith. I rather enjoyed drinking with him. Wardrop, too. Though the man could not hold his liquor. He and Weeks never got along.
Ugh. conscience, Guest. You've succeeded.
We live in a time of war, Shay, but it's always wartime for us. I sound like my uncle Jedediah. He was an old sourpuss. Let me tell you.
Another time, Guest.
Aye, sir. Worthy catch. We may discover new lands out here, even if they are buried under 3 feet of snow.
Fire! Get me some
speed!
Lord, but
that's
right
to the bone.
Fire! Hit her from us!
We missed!
Hold down! Hold down!
Ready, Captain!
Fire! Loose a trip to... Let's move! And gallants.
Ice ram is cutting through.
He's off the wind. Call it all sail.
Has the helm.
Loose and cuts the wind.
Check every sail.
The ice isn't stopping us.
Loose all and trim sharp to the wind. Douse the royals and tops! Or sail! All sail! Trim us off the wind!
Anchor!
Double les patrouilles jusqu'à nouvel ordre.
Thank you.
d'Astérien jusqu'à ce qu'il se remette de sa blessure.
On en reparlera demain.
Done.